Hello everyone and welcome to this tutorial how to set up Gitea with TeamCity. Our goal is to have TeamCity update the status check in Gitea on every new commit that gets pushed to the repository. And to get the green check mark here next to each commit or next to each pushed commit if the TeamCity build has successfully finished, and we'll also get the status check down here when the build has finished. Apart from being able to see in Gitea if the build failed or passed, we can also add some rules based on the status check, like in this case where I don't allow merging of the pull request until the check is successful. So when I recently switched from GitHub to Gitea, I was under the impression that Gitea and TeamCity would not play ball out of the box. But it's actually not that hard to set up, so let's get started. I have created a basic Unity project as a starting point. While I'm using a Unity project for this demo, the concepts that we'll go through will apply to pretty much any kind of project. And I've already set up a repository in Gitea and I push the project to it. I'm running Gitea and TeamCity in Docker containers on my local network. However, the process will remain the same no matter what kind of installation you have of these two applications. The primary difference you would encounter would be the specific URLs you are using for your instances. Okay, let's go and get Gitea and TeamCity set up for some continuous integration. We will start by setting up a project in TeamCity that we can connect to Gitea. First, let's create a new project. I usually use SSH, but I haven't added my key to TeamCity at this time, so we'll go with HTTPS in this case. I'm just going to copy this URL and my username. And I'm going to need to use an access token as I don't use an SSH key connection. I have an access token I have generated that I can just paste in here. You can generate your own token in your Gitea account if you don't have one. You will find it under the application section. There you can create the token like I've done here, where I have one for TeamCity. And as I mentioned, if you use an SSH key, you don't have to bother with this. Okay, let's proceed. And now TeamCity is connected to the Gitea repository and we have a project that we can create for it. Let's just go with the default values and proceed. And there we go. We now have a new project called Unity Gitea TeamCity. It's connected to the repository and we have a default build configuration that we can work with. We need to add a build step to the build configuration. Let's just return our repository in Gitea. Okay, so we are going to add the build step just to give TeamCity something to build while we are setting this up. Let's go into edit configuration and then go to build steps. I'm going to add the command line build step. I prefer to use command line build steps over dedicated plugins as they are portable between CI systems. I've been using Jenkins and I've been using GitHub Actions, and as I use command line steps, I can use the same build step pretty much anywhere as is. That's very convenient instead of getting locked into a specific system when, like I can get when you use the available pipeline steps. I'm just going to copy and paste my command to build this Unity project. This basically just runs the test suite for this project. And this is very specific for this project. And it doesn't really matter when it comes to this demonstration. Every project would have something different here. So this is added so we have something to test with. And this is not a Unity tutorial, so I won't go into what these parameters do. So let's save. And now we have a build step. Let's start the build so we can see that TeamCity can check out the repository and runs the test suite. I'm going back to the project page and I'm going to run this build. This will take half a minute or so, and I will just fast forward this video to the end. And there we go. We have a successful build and the setup worked so far. TeamCity can now build the project. Now we want to have instant automation. What we want to do next is to automate the triggering of the builds. While TeamCity actually checks the repository in intervals, looking for new commits, it's still a delay between the commit and the build actually starting. And we want it to be instant, so we will use a webhook for that. To be able to use webhooks in Gitea, we have to whitelist the webhook destination. And this is for the entire server, not per project, so you will have to do this once. To be able to whitelist the webhook, you need to edit the configuration file of your Gitea server. That's your app.ini file. Somewhere in that file, you need to add a webhook section, unless you already have it. In this section, you can set up your allowed host list. And here you can see that I have added the URL to my TeamCity instance. As soon as I've added this, Gitea is allowed to post webhooks to trigger builds in TeamCity from any repository. You can keep adding to this list. As you can see here, I also have my issue tracker whitelisted here. So once this is done, you can start setting up the actual webhook. The URL for the webhook to use is not that straightforward to find as one could expect it to be. It's a little bit hidden away in the documentation for TeamCity. You can find the relevant information under the post commit hook section in the manual for TeamCity. The webhook is actually an API call to the REST API. It is a post request to the URL of your server. And then you have this app REST VCS route instances commit hook notification part. And then finally, a locator, which specifies which repository something happened in. The route instance location of the URL can be specified in two different ways. It can either be done by setting the actual URL to the repository, or you can find an ID for the repository by making a one-time API request to get another identifier and use that for a much neater URL. I haven't really bothered with that. I'm sticking with this one, the URL-based one, as I just have to add it once anyway. Once it's set in Gitea, it's there and won't have to be touched again. If we check here, this is the webhook URL I use for another project. This is the URL to the TeamCity instance in my local network. And then we have https://gitealanbitbop.com/the username, which is bitbop/bitloop.git. And then just a few extra properties at the end. And that's it. Let's tweak this one. We have the username here, which is Johan. And then we have the repository name, Unity Gitea TeamCity. Let's just copy Johan and replace bitbebop. And let's copy the repository name and replace blitloop. And that would be the webhook to use for this project. So we're going to copy it. And then we're going to settings, webhooks, add a webhook. We choose Gitea and paste the URL. Post is fine. Trigger on push events is also fine. Then we're going to need to authenticate when posting the webhook via a request header. To be able to do that, we're going to need to create a token in TeamCity that we use in this header. You can create the token in profile and then go to access token. I've already done that, so I have my Gitea token here. So I'm going to copy it from where I have it saved. And we're going back to Gitea and we're going to add bearer and then just paste in the token in this field. That should be it. Let's add the webhook. We're going to check so it works. So we do that by going to test delivery. Hopefully it's going to work. Okay, we got the green check mark. It got posted. TeamCity responded, so it works. Let's make a quick change to the repository to test it. So I'm going back to our project here. Let's get my terminal and just make a quick repository change. I'm going to add a README file. Save it. And then I'll just add the change. And push it. And there we go. We instantly have a build pending already. So the webhook worked. And there the build started. I'm just going to let it finish. Well, this now works. Gitea does not yet get informed about the status of the builds. We have two commits here, but there is no indication of the test having been run, succeeded, or failed. That is what we're going to deal with next. Let's add the status checks to Gitea so we can get the outcome reported back from TeamCity. First of all, let's create a feature branch so we have something to test with. I'm just going to add a new branch here. Update README. And let's just update the README. Save this. Updated README. Commit. And push it. Hopefully it should be picked up by TeamCity right away. There we go. It's now building the new branch. Let's make a pull request so we can see what's going on. Updated README. Create pull request. Here's where we want to see the status check from TeamCity. To be able to do that is actually quite simple, as Gitea's API is compatible with GitHub's API in this regard. By that, we can use the GitHub integration for status checks in TeamCity. We're going to need a Gitea access token, and we already created one before when we connected to the repository via HTTPS, so we can reuse the same token for this. Let's go into the configuration for our build, and we're going to add a build feature. We will use the one called Commit Status Publisher. Here we're going to choose GitHub, but we have our own API, right? So we're going to change this to our own URL. I'm going to copy my URL from here. So this is now gitealon.bitbob.com/API/v1. And that's it. That's the URL. I'm then going to paste in my Gitea token. Let's test the connection. And we have the connection working. Let's save this. Next time we make a build in TeamCity, it should be reported back to Gitea. Let's make a small modification to test that. Save this. Go back to the project. Commit the change. Let's push it. The build has started. We now have a pending status check in Gitea. TeamCity build started. We also have a status indicator next to the actual commit. Now we're done, the build has finished. And we have a green check mark. So, that's it. We now have a working status check in Gitea being updated on each build triggered in TeamCity. We can now see directly in Gitea the status of all our tests, if they passed or failed. We can also use this for branch protection. We can protect our main branch and enable status check to not allow merging unless we have a successful test suite. That's it. I hope you found this helpful. Check out my Discord if you have any questions. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.